A young sapling with time grows into a bigger plant. So what is supporting this plant so that it can stand erect on the soil? Well, the tissues that is making up the plant, namely the parenchyma tissue, the colenchyma tissue, and the sclerenchyma tissue, all of which are permanent tissues, tissues that have lost the ability to divide and grow any further, forms the supporting tissue of the plant. So all these three tissues forms a plant, and these three tissues allow the plant to have this erect and rigid nature. Now the two conducting pipelines present in the plants, known as the xylem and the phloem, also consists of many dead cells. Like in the phloem, there is the phloem fibers, and the xylem has the trachea and the tracheids. These dead cells have a very thick and a lignified cell wall. So these dead cells provide mechanical support to the plant, and hence the xylem and the phloem forms the supporting tissue of the plant as well. So leaves are exposed to the environmental stresses. They have to withstand torrential storm or rain. So what gives protection to the leaves? Just like you and me, we have skin that protects the inner organs or the more delicate blood vessels and the nerves. Plant has an outer coating which is protective in nature. This is the outer coating that gives protection to the leaves and the other plant parts. And this outermost coating of the plant is known as the epidermal tissue. So just like you and me, we have skin, plants have epidermal tissue. So this epidermal layer in the young sapling was a single layer formed of parenchyma cells. Now parenchyma cells are living cells. But when the young sapling grows into a huge tree over the time, the parenchyma cells die and they form the sclerenchyma cells, which have a thick and a lignified cell wall. So the sclerenchyma forms the bark, which is the outer hard covering of a plant. So this bark provides a lot of protection to the plant because it is hard, it is tough, and it is rigid. So the bark is made up of, this bark is made up of sclerenchyma cells, which get converted from the parenchyma cells of the epidermal tissue that is formed or found in the young sapling. See, the bark of the plant gives so much of protection to the plant that it can give protection against dangerous and formidable insects like the stag beetle. So the epidermal tissue, which is made up of parenchyma cells, later converts to form the bark, which is made up of sclerenchyma cells. They become hard and lignified and gives a lot of protection to the plant.